As Barbados strengthens surveillance at its ports of entry to protect its citizens against the novel coronavirus, intensive training of frontline workers at the Grantley Adams International Airport and the Bridgetown Port is ongoing. These workers are Barbados' first line of defense against the disease, and Medical Officer of Health in the Ministry of Health and Wellness, Dr. Manohar Singh, is leading a team of health professionals charged with sensitizing the port workers about the protocols which they need to adhere to.
Port workers means it's a general term, but it contains everyone, GA Inc. employees, immigration, customs, and also concierge, and also other all the department, including the environmental department of the ports, and also the custodian team, red caps, everybody, all the people would be sensitized. This is the training is a port health team. Port health is a separate system. It's a department, comes under the Ministry of Health and Wellness. So we have a team, doctors, and also environmental health officers and port health nurses. This is the teamwork. We are the team. We are doing all the sensitization.
Training has been extensive and intensive so that all categories of workers are included.
So every day and also nights also we are doing. Especially first day we started with 4 sessions, but ended up with 6 sessions because so many people have, they're coming and they. And also last night also the session in the midnight, it is started in the night to 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock for the night session, night shift workers. And also today is the 2 more sessions is going to be. And after that, those who are unable to come, immigration, customs, and other the essential departments, so we are going to their departments to sensitize them.
The best way to prevent infection is to avoid being exposed. This can be done by avoiding touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with unwashed hands, washing your hands often and with soap and water for at least 20 seconds, or using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer if soap and water are not available.
Hand hygiene is very, very important thing, hand hygiene. So that's why the different session for the each department we will go and teach them hand technique training, how to do that hand wash and also personal hygiene also.
Dr. Singh explained the protocol in place for persons arriving from the affected regions.
If the person is suspected case, when they come to the contact with the first immigration or customs, we'll take them up immediately and also we'll keep them up passive surveillance. That means passive quarantine. And we will advise them in case the signs and symptoms, the first signs and symptoms based on the WHO, fever, cough, and breathlessness, and the cold symptoms. Once it is developed, immediately these people will be isolated and kept in the isolation place in the hospital, start the treatment. So that is the procedure we have.
There are also plans to execute a simulation exercise.
We planned for the simulation exercise. How we did it for the last time? We did it for the SARS, we did it for the MERS-CoV, we did it for the H1N1, we did it for the pandemic influenza. Last year, we did it for the Ebola too. So this, the live simulation is Ministry of Health, Queen Elizabeth Hospital, Infection Control, Defense Force, GA Inc., and Port Inc., Ambulance Services, and also finally the Defense Force with the private ambulance also. All together, we will do that.
Medical Officer of Health in the Ministry of Health and Wellness, Dr. Manohar Singh. Minister of Health and Wellness, Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey Bostick, stressed that persons from places outside of China will also be monitored.
We know there's a lot of traffic coming through the United States, and I don't want you to think that we're only focusing on China, but it's about managing risk. At the moment, there have been about 8 cases in the United States, I think 4 states, but there has been no spread. If they spread in any one of those states, then we would have to step up our thing in terms of people coming from that region. There's no spread, and so we'll still treat people the same way as they come in, we will not focus at this point in the same way that we will focus on people coming through China or from China.
Minister of Health and Wellness, Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey Bostick, as he addressed frontline workers during a training session on the novel coronavirus 2019, recently held at the Grantley Adams International Airport, Inc. Keep listening for more updates from the ministry as they come to hand.